Doomer Dan returns home from work, turns on Netflix, and watches his favorite show. The same recycled 70s laugh track and the same recycled cliche plot lines occupy his mind. Why am I doing this? What's the point of it all if the world is just gonna end anyways? The days all feel the same and the nights blend together to form a collage of experiences, each as trivial as the other, all counting down to a grand finale. A collapse of society. Enter the Doomer. The Doomer views life as meaningless and sees no purpose in it. In constant worry of an impending collapse, worried about global problems such as overpopulation, peak oil, and pollution. The term first popularized by 4chan, where users had begun creating Wojak caricatures with the Umer suffix to mock various groups online. One of these caricatures was Doomers. 20-somethings who had simply stopped trying. The Doomer's life revolves around a simple structure day in and day out, drowning himself in drugs and entertainment to express his dissatisfaction with the course of the world and its vices. The Doomer is the end result of rampant doom scrolling and pessimism that leads one to clock out of life. Everyone either knows a Doomer or experiences similar characteristics themselves. The Doomer view of life is not a modern concept. It harkens back to Malthusian thought. Thomas Robert Malthus was an English cleric, scholar, and influential economist in the fields of political economy and demography. His magnum opus was published in 1798, named An Essay on the Principle of Population. He asserts that while population growth is exponential, food production is linear, leading to an inevitable catastrophe of death and destruction. Critics of Malthus argued that although his theories carried weight at the time, he failed to predict the Industrial Revolution, which boosted food production exponentially. The harsh reality is that no one can accurately predict the future. Although Malthusian thought has since died out, Neo-Malthusianism echoes a similar sentiment and has carried on throughout the years. Fast forward to the end of the Second World War, and America experienced a boom in prosperity, and with it came the baby boom. 76 million children were born during the baby boom in an era known for suburbanization and wage growth. The optimism of the nation was at an all-time high, and consumer confidence saw families spending copious amounts on credit, housing, furnishing, and many other expenses. However, like all booms, it eventually came to an end. The endless credit and monetary policies eventually led to a thinning of the middle class. The abundance of wealth creation and status elevation that defined the American dream became more and more out of reach and simply unattainable for the average family. Coincidentally, innovations in technology allowed for the spread of information to occur at faster and faster rates. With the advent of home computing and early internet message boards such as AOL and Microsoft Chat, users all across the world were able to share their experiences and communicate. As many of the luxuries enjoyed by the baby boomer generation became more and more unaffordable for younger generations, the gap has never become clearer. With more and more youth believing homeownership and wealth creation are simply unattainable, this phenomenon has developed a generation of individuals disconnected from the aims and wants of society around them. They seek like-minded individuals to reinforce their worldview in the age of bubbles and echo chambers, and they find them in the deep crevices of the internet. The Doomer laments the inability to achieve much of what previous generations could and scrolls incessantly to fill the void. As the old English proverb goes, an idle brain is the devil's workshop. A more interconnected world is one that shares opportunities and innovations, however, it also shares its issues and burdens as well. The first-hand effects of this generational disconnect can be felt across the world. With the lowering rates of marriage, homeownership, men attending higher education, and their participation in the workforce, a counterculture of pessimism and cynicism has emerged, leading many to become disillusioned within their societies. A perfect example of this phenomenon is the rise of the shut-in, or hikikomori, inside the land of the rising sun, Japan. The term first coined by Japanese psychologist Tamaki Saito in his 1998 book Social Withdrawal, Adolescence Without End. The term literally means pulling inwards or being confined, describing total withdrawal from society and seeking extreme degrees of social isolation and confinement. These shared experiences, although slightly different in the Western Hemisphere, share similar roots. An abundance of cheap communication, entertainment, plus a sense of angst and directionlessness create an ever-growing abundance of doomers. The principal cause of such is the lack of meaning provided by traditional aspirations. Being told from a young age that life was about going to university, getting a job, owning a home, only to achieve those things and ask, now what? Was it all worth it? Traditional beacons of meaning and purpose within the Western world had experienced decades of decline into obscurity, relegated to a small segment of society, leaving citizens purposeless. The doomer busies himself with the world's issues and a coming collapse in order to absolve himself of responsibility. If the world will end in 10 years due to X, why ameliorate your own situation? Wallowing in cynicism and self-pity, they seek meaning to define themselves in this modern age. This concept is best illustrated in the novel The Will to Power by a little-known philosopher Friedrich Nietzsche, where he writes, "What I relate is the history of the next two centuries. I describe what is coming, what can no longer come differently, the advent of nihilism. For some time now, our whole European culture has been moving towards a catastrophe." The future nihilism that Nietzsche once predicted is now a reality. Many people now see themselves in the doomer, and they are not alone. Studies show more and more Americans now view the future with a pessimistic outlook. Pew Research finds about 3/4 of all Americans, 73%, expect the gap between the rich and the poor to grow over the next 30 years, a view shared by large majorities across major demographic and political groups. Individuals diving deeper and deeper into their respective bubbles in an effort to redefine themselves. No doubt this trend of doomer mentality has been exacerbated by advances in communication. Traditionally, social isolation has required serious resolve and concentration to achieve, typically reserved for hermits or ascetics. However, with the availability of ever-engaging mediums such as the metaverse, the trend will only continue to grow. This week's featured comment comes from our video on doom scrolling. He writes about a time when he found himself addicted to doom scrolling and isolated for long periods of time. I agree 100% that doom scrolling is an easy escape from the monotony of the world around us. I myself have experienced a similar situation and believe the best solution for it is to understand that we control our access to information and not the other way around. If you liked the video, give it a like. If you loved it, subscribe and make sure to have your comment so I can feature it next week. As always, stay solid and don't surf.